Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome back to Repair and Replace. In this episode, I'll show you how to install a TOTO EcoPower flushometer. To begin, you'll need a flushometer, a smooth jaw wrench, a flat blade screwdriver, and a 1/8 inch security hex wrench. You might also need a pipe cutter, solder flux paste, lead-free solder, and a blowtorch. First, dry fit the flushometer in place to check the height and position. Starting from the top of the fixture, measure up to the middle of the supply line. Water closets and urinals will have a max height of 11.5 inches. And a flush pipe can be trimmed down to a different height if needed. If you measure from the center of the supply line to the center of the valve, it should be 4.25 to 5.25 inches. Next, measure from the wall to the center line. It should be a minimum of 1.5 inches away. Now check the length of the copper tube. Measure from the wall to the center line of the flushometer. The copper tube should be 1 inch shorter than that distance. Cut the pipe if necessary. Next, solder the adapter to the copper tube to secure it in place. Cut the cover tube 1.5 inches shorter than the center line measurement. Slide the wall flange and cover tube over the supply pipe. Now, screw the inlet stop onto the adapter. Use a smooth jaw wrench to tighten it into place. Next, install the spud or flush pipe. Slide on the vacuum breaker coupling. Next, slide on the spud coupling assembly, which is made up of the coupling nut, flange, friction ring, and rubber washer. Align the flush pipe and hand tighten the nut. Now, assemble the vacuum breaker. Slide the plastic insert into the lip of the rubber sleeve and place the washer over top. Now, insert the vacuum breaker into the flush pipe. Set the flushometer body on the flush pipe and hand tighten the tailpiece coupling and hex coupling. Now, use a smooth jaw wrench to secure each connection. To activate the unit, you'll have to install the backup battery. First, slide the battery into the mounting bracket and connect the wires. Now, connect the wires to the solenoid and generator. Now, replace the cover and tighten the set screws. After the battery is connected, it will take about 5 minutes for the electronics to fully initialize. The red light will flash in 4-second intervals until the initialization is completed. The sensor's detection range is preset, will not need any adjustment. Turn on the shutoff valve to the supply line. Next, use a flat blade screwdriver to open the control stop one full turn. Now, test the flushometer. The first flush should eliminate all the air from the lines. If this is a new installation, it is recommended to flush the valve 4 or 5 times to clean out the supply line of any debris. Now, adjust the control stop until you get a normal flush with a quiet operation. Finally, replace the cap. If you found this video useful, then subscribe to our channel. We're constantly filming new content every week, so let us know what repairs you'd like to see next. Now, if you need a part for that repair, then explore our website. We stock thousands of hard-to-find parts, and we'll ship it out to you the same day. Thanks for watching.